This space which contains everything
yes.
is also perceivable.
Yeah.
But the nothing which contains space,
yes.
that doesn't seem to be perceivable. Yeah. Even though when I try to say it, the mind creates some image.
Very good. Okay, so stay there. You say that this nothing is not perceivable. Beautiful. So how is it known?
Something higher knows it.
Exactly. And you know it.
But I still...
So the I that knows it is which one?
The small I tries to buy it, the knowing.
So let it try. What is the truth? This is a very beautiful point he's making. He says it is not perceivable and yet it is known. Is it? So what is that which is unperceivable and yet known? What kind of knowing is that? Huh? You see, this is a beautiful knowing. Because our knowing has been so just conceptual knowing or phenomenal knowing. Now he's saying it is unperceivable and yet I know it. Which know must this be? Capital K.
But the small eye is like, what do I do with it?
The small eye. The cat. See, one good part about the cat story was that it also pointed to a very important truth. What does the cat do? Don't be afraid of sounding silly. I'm going to sound very silly in a minute. Huh? The cat does meow. What does it mean?
Meow.
Me. Ow. Anytime you pick up the me, the ow is coming. You see? So the small eye is doing meow, meow. Let it come and go. You see, that is the mantra of the cat anyway. What gift do you want to give to the small eye?
I want the small eye to disappear. Not disappear, dissolve.
Is it the small eye that wants the small eye to disappear? Can we look at this?
Smaller eye wants the small eye to disappear.
It is a thief posing as a policeman wanting to catch the thief. Is the reality of you in opposition to any appearance?
No.